لك الحمد ولك الشكر على نعمك علينا ظاهرة وباطنة. يا ربي ما حمدناك حق حمد ولا شكرناك حق شكر ولا عبدناك حق عبادة، ولكنك تتكرم علينا كما عودتنا من رحمتك ورأفتك وعطفك علينا. خلقتنا فرزقتنا فهديتنا، ولئن عصيناك أمهلتنا، ولئن عدنا إليك قبلتنا. ما أرحمك ما أعظمك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. مالك الملك، بيده ملكوت السماوات والأرض، الرحمن الرحيم، العدل، نعمه صبغت العالم كله، خلق الكون من لا شيء. سبحان الله. من كلمات الإمام علي عليه السلام، حقيقة احنا حرمنا من هذا العلم. الإمام علي يقول أول الدين معرفته، معرفة الله، وكمال معرفته التصديق به، وكمال التصديق به توحيده، وكمال توحيده الإخلاص له، وكمال الإخلاص له نفي الصفات عنه، إلى آخر. حقيقة كلمات ومعاني تحتاج إلى تدبر عميق في معرفة الله عز وجل. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. وأشهد أن محمداً عبدك ورسولك وصفيك من خلقك وخليلك، أدى رسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلى الله عليك يا علم الهدى، ما هبت النسائم وما ناحت على الأيك الحمائم. أما بعد، all of my praise belongs to you, oh Allah. يعطيك العافية أستاذ سامي الأخ العزيز الغالي، وربنا يحفظك ويحفظنا جميعا، وشفاكم الله من الوعكة اللي مريت فيها. يعني all of my praise belongs to you, oh Allah. I bear witness that there is no deity but you, and the one and the only one, the creator and the sustainer of the universe. We have never thanked you sufficiently, O Allah. Neither we have worshipped you sufficiently, O Allah. Nor anyone that have thanked you sufficiently, nor anyone have worshipped you sufficiently, that you have created us from nothing. We've created us from nothing. And then you sustain us. And then you guide us. You don't leave us alone. You guide us. And we go astray, O Allah. And you're compassionate with us, patient with us. That when we come back to you seeking forgiveness, you receive us with your warmth of love and forgiveness. What a merciful one, O Allah, the creator and the sustainer of the universe. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is your last and final messenger who came with the glad tidings and who came with the guidance to all humanity. My dear friends, brothers and sisters in Islam, and also my friends in humanity, my brothers and sisters in humanity. As we are going through this crisis that is probably intended to bring us closer to the Creator and to put things in proper perspectives, to put the proper priorities in our life in its place. So as well that we can see that we also need to take care of our planet, that our planet as well is telling us that we need to consider that aspect for our own goods. So there's so many goods comes out of this. إخوتي وأخواتي في الله في خضم هذه الأيام أيام الجائحة جائحة كورونا وكذلك ونحن نمر بأيام رمضان ولياليه حقيقة رمضان مختلف عن كل الرمضانات عام يختلف عن كل الأعوام لعل الله عز وجل يريد لنا أن نرجع إلى الوراء ونفكر قليلا حتى نضع الأولويات في مكانها لعلنا كنا نسير وننطلق بسرعة فائقة ولا نلتفت يمينا ولا يسارا ولا نلتفت لمن هو أهم ومن هو مهم ومن هو أقل أهمية لعلنا أعطينا اهتمام لأشياء على حساب أشياء أخرى كذلك كوكبنا يصرخ وينادي لعلنا أسأنا استخدامه فيريد منا كذلك أن نتروى وأن ننظر إلى الأمور بطريقة نتحلى فيها بالحكمة حكمة لأنفسنا ولأولادنا ولمجتمعنا وللعالم كذلك أنا حاجة كلمتي بالإنجليزي وبالعربة وأخوات طلبوا مني تحديدا أني أتكلم بالعربي ولكن هنا أنا في ضيافة الحقيقة نسيت أقول أن أنا في ضيافة مسجد النور ومسجد النور الآن هو كم يدعونا في مواسم وفي صلوات وفي جمع وفي دروس الآن حتى طلبوا مني قليلاً لأنه المسجد النور for this spent in this special time this special time this special Ramadan that's unlike any prior Ramadans we have experienced in our life in this special Ramadan that we are in isolation if you will we are in tahajjud in continuous i'tikaf if you will continuous seclusion to oneself in isolation in reflection of the priorities in life priorities for our own self for our family for our society for the world and for our planet that maybe we've been running so fast maybe we were not putting the priorities in the proper orders, something that we made more important than others, that it gave us a chance to take a deep breath and think of what is really the source of happiness, what would make us happy in this life. And then we can think together. يعني لأنه لعله حقيقة إنه هذا العالم يعني يقبل على الإسلام طوعا يعني بخلاف ما كان يحدث في التاريخ الماضي وفيه أخطاء يعني حقيقة ليس الآن الوارد الدخول فيها أو الحوار عنها لكن نحن بحاجة للتروي وبحاجة لتفكر لأولويات الحياة. Today, I am going to reflect with you, especially I'm talking to our youngsters, our special ones from Masjid al-Nur, may Allah bless them. I have some of them actually contacted me out of the blue from none other than, from other places, from even from Michigan. Someone contacted me that to say, we have missed these lectures and we want to see. And of course, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I benefit myself first before anyone else, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to practice what we say and not to ask for the impossible, but to dwell with gentleness and with proper footsteps toward the refining oneself to be in the best form that Allah has intended for us, that we are in the best way we conduct ourselves that our Creator wants from us. What does the Creator wants from us? Does he want from us to be a tools of viciousness, a tools of killing, a tools of hurting, a tools of grabbing from one another? Or does the Creator want from us to be a tool of healing, a tool of kindness, a tool of sharing, that I don't go to sleep full while my neighbor is hungry? What a beautiful example that we can set to the whole humanity, and let the humanity, let people think and reflect and come from their own way of thinking. La ikraha fi al-deen. There is no compulsion on the way of life. You try this, you try that, these things take you to nowhere, this road takes you to some more misery and more. Is the happiness in the wealth? Is the happiness in a big house? Is the happiness in what is the source of this happiness? How can we be happy? But today, I'm going to reflect on a special topic that I was talking with my brothers about, because also I was deep thinking, if you will, of the status we are in and what are we doing that's not working. And also, being a scientist, that I have done so many experiments, that my scientific and Islamic background tells me, if I do something, if I do an experiment and I see Martin Barclay, may God bless you, if I conduct an experiment and I fail and I repeat it again and I fail and I repeat it again and I fail and I repeat it exactly the same way and I fail, it's time to sit back and to think of why this is happening. Maybe the way I'm conducting the experiments needs to be corrected, needs to be modified, needs to be refined. But for the sake of my community, the small community, if you will, and as well as the large community, they will benefit as well. This is for Masjid al-Nur, al-Nur Islamic Center, which is in North Kansas City. It's one of the few places that I have seen so many of the youngsters have memorized the Quran here in Kansas City, in the heart of America. And I have seen them put a special respect to Allah, special respect to the Prophet and to all the prophets, special respect to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that they have a special occasion for the birth of the Prophet. They have a special occasion for Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, the night journey of the Prophet. And so many of the things that made me see how this community, may God bless them and bless their leadership for the way they have conducted themselves to be the best citizen a country could have, the best community that will produce the best mother and the best father, that will produce a good family that will benefit all humanity. Today, I am going to reflect on some of the ayat, some of the verses that relates to the character of the al-musallin, the one who perform the salat, the one who perform the prayers. Many times we perform the prayers, but we have to ask ourselves. And I'm addressing specifically our youngsters, because they are the future leader of this ummah. So the future leader of the community, the future men and ladies of the community. As we perform our salat, our prayer, we need to ask ourselves, is it a ritual, that emotion that we go through, that we have done our obligation, and then we move on to our daily life like nothing has happened? Or is there benefit comes out of it? Are we getting those benefits that out of this prayer? Then this prayer is doing its job. But if we are going through the ritual of the salat and nothing happens, we don't see any improvement in the quality of our life, then there's something serious that we really need to go back and revisit how we perform this prayer. What is the purpose of this prayer? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. This book, there is no doubt about it. هدى للمتقين. It's a guidance. This book is a guidance to those who have piety, those who are self-conscious. A one who is self-conscious, who's in alert non-stop. Wherever he walks, he or she, whatever he's dealing with, whether people are watching, whether people are not watching, that person has an internal guard. Those are al-muttaqeen. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Who are those muttaqeen? الَّذِينَ, those they are يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. They believe in the unseen. They believe in the unseen. They believe in the that there are things out there that we may not have seen. They believe in the unseen. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ. And they establish a regular prayer. This is وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ, that comes number two. So الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And from what we have provided for them, from wealth, they spend. I'm going to stop here and take you to Surah Al-Ma'arij and take you to Surah Al-Mu'mineen, Surah Al-Mu'minun, to reflect on the character of those who perform the prayer, for those who keep their salat. Does what characters they are supposed to have in order for us to say that this salat, this prayer has fulfilled its obligation. We find nine characters. Before getting into it, I would like to say, when an individual have the intention to do the salat, the first moment that person gets in his or her mind, I'm getting up to pray Asr, to do the Asr prayer, that is a moment of preparedness, a moment where the brain start telling us, let us keep our focus. Maybe I'm busy with my work. Maybe I'm busy with my family. Maybe I'm busy with my studying. Maybe I'm busy counting money and business. All kind of, maybe I'm busy playing. It's okay. I'm busy playing. But then when I'm ready, I'm telling myself I'm getting ready to do the Asr prayer. This is where my mind is telling me to start getting focused and start getting everything outside. Start getting myself in preparedness to meet with whom? I'm not meeting with the president of the country or the mayor of this. They are good people. They are important people. But I'm getting ready to meet with my Creator. Wow, this is amazing. When you are in a mental state, getting ready to do that, what do you do next? You go to take an ablution, to make wudu, and also we don't want to waste water. I see a lot of people when they do their wudu, I say, Allahu Akbar. We are really, while intending to do something good, in the same time we are doing something terrible. We are wasting water. You see, the faucet opened all the way. Just, we take a little bit of water and wash our hand, wash our face, wash our arm, the right arm, and then the left arm. And then with a wet hand, I touch my forehead and the front of my feet. This water, I'm a scientist, and I tell my student, I can talk about water nonstop for a whole semester, and I will not fulfill the all the character of this molecule that's called water. And the simplest thing I ask them, when we go to other planets to look for life, what do we look for? We look for water. So we wash ourselves with this water. We prepare ourselves. It's a preparedness to meet with our Creator. Then we stand. This is a reported stories of Imam Hussein. When he is getting ready to do his prayer, and as he's getting closer to do that, his whole appearance changes. Maybe he was laughing with his friends, playing with his kids, doing business, but as he's getting ready for the salat, he become more in a state of preparedness to meet the Creator. That's the only way I can say it. As you are getting ready to meet with someone important, do we want to make sure that we get this feeling as we are getting ready to do the salat, and then we stand in front of this Creator. We should feel that we are standing in front of our Creator. And as we stand in front of our Creator, what do we do? How do we enter this conversation? Direct conversation. Yes, between you and your Creator. Between me and my Creator. Between each individual and directly with the, we don't need someone in between us. We don't need mediators. We are doing it directly with our Kriya. Can you imagine when you are standing there to meet with your Creator? Many times we do the Salat on a fast lane, in a hurry, because we have other things to do. And let alone when we enter the Salat, million things comes to our mind. This business I didn't finish. This person said so and so to me, or I'm planning to this to do. We do. It's a moment where we're supposed to empty our mind. We're supposed to be focused. In fact, when we stand, what do? The very, very first thing that we do, we raise our hand. Like, if I have the whole world, I am carrying it with my hand and throwing it behind me. Many people don't realize what does it mean. I am throwing everything behind me. Business, life, I am emptying everything so that I can meet with Allah. So I'm meeting with my Creator. And what do I say? Allahu Akbar. God is greater. Greater than the business that I was doing earlier, the study that I was doing. People talk about meditation. But this is the ultimate, when you completely empty your mind from all of these worldly matters, which are important, but for just a few minutes. How this will impact on your blood pressure. You'll come back fresh. How you are going to conduct yourself the rest of the day after you do this prayer. So when you say Allahu Akbar, God is greater, and then you start performing your salat. Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزْوًا. Okay, here is my son, Al-Hassan. Say, Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
And he is saying hello to everyone. Where is your brother, Hussein?
Yes.
Yeah, go get him so he can say, Assalamu alaikum. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا, that humankind has been created to be in a hurry, in a rush. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ, I'm going to look at the translation here, so that truly man was created very impatient. And this is تعالى بابا, تعالى, تعالى. This is Al-Hussein, of course. Assalamu alaikum. You think you saw the same person, but it is his twin brother. So that's why we look the same. Say, Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
Allah, Allah, mashallah. And this is Noor al-Huda. Assalamu alaikum. Are you reading some Quran?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, say, Assalamu alaikum to everyone.
Assalamu alaikum.
Allah, Allah. See, Ammu Ahmed, Dr. Madi is here on the phone with us. Yalla, Allah. إن الإنسان خلق هلوعا. Man, truly, man was created very impatient. You know this joke that someone is praying to God, oh God, I want patience, but I want it now. And he's so, even in the request, there's no patience in it. Truly, man was created very impatient. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلْوَعًا إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا. If harm comes on his way, he is جَزُوع. يعني he almost wants to commit a suicide, which we have seen. He lose patience. He lose hope. He lose himself. إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ, إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا. I memorize this ayat, but when I like to do tadabbur, I like to keep looking at the ayat, and I don't lose myself this way. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا إذا مسه الشر جزوعا. When harm comes on his way, he is جزوع. He loses himself, loses patience. And niggardly when fruitful when evil touches him. Fruitful when evil, the translation is written in old English. I like to use modern understood language to everyone. That when harm comes on his way, he loses himself. إذا مسه الشر وإذا مسه الخير منوعا. When he gets good things, he deprives everyone else. He is miser. When good things comes his way, he doesn't share. When harm things comes on his way, he is totally impatient with it and very unhappy with that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, "Inna al-insana," that human, خلق, was created with this character, هلوع, very impatient, that when harm comes on his way, he loses himself, and when he receives some goods, he deprives everyone else. But then he put an exception. إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ, except for those who perform the salat. This is very important. I really want that we can see where we went wrong so that we are able to improve in oneself. Improve in oneself, improve in the family, improve in the community, improve in the society. When one person set a good example and other people follow that example, and more people follow this good example, you will find a whole city with a good example. إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ. Now, we are going to get into the characters of these مُصَلِّينَ. الْمُصَلِّينَ are those, it's a sifa to someone who perform salah, who perform prayer. إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ, except for those who perform the prayer. الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَى صَلَاتِهِمْ دَائِمُونَ. So it is, they are the one who are continuously keeping the pattern, the tradition of prayer. So it's not being disconnected. He prays today, he prayed yesterday, he prayed the day before, he prays tomorrow. الَّذِينَ هُمْ على صلاتهم دائمون. And I'm really not going to go into more of the detail. So for the sake of time, and also for the sake of getting the benefits as best as we can with the least amount of detail here. إلا المصلين الذين هم على صلاتهم دائمون. والذين, see this is another character, والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم. And they are the one that in their wealth there is some rights. Do we have rights upon our wealth? We do. If I work, God Almighty has blessed me with some talent and some strength that I'm earning more than someone else. Does this wealth that I earn, are there rights on it? Yes. And of course, I'm going to say it in general, but of course there are specific. These rights belong to those who do not have. That I don't live in luxury while there are others in famine. That I'm throwing some leftover food and some others don't even have the food. And actually, talking about that, I saw a picture of a lady in Gaza on Facebook from someone, a new friend on Facebook from Gaza. This lady in a house, half of it is destroyed and using some plastic for the roof. And see, this is an example. I reposted and I said, is there anywhere we can we help? Of course, I've seen good work done by organizations such as Heart to Heart International. They went in the midst of the crisis in New York, a team of doctors with Heart to Heart International and nurses going in the midst of the crisis in New York to help over there. والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم. The wealth that you have, there are some rights upon it, that some of it needs to be taken out and need to be given to someone who is less fortunate. My wife is looking at me. And of course, when your wife comes to look at you, you have to stand. Why are you smiling? Yeah, this is the truth. Yeah. والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم. On their wealth, there is rights. That I have this $1,000, a chunk of it, $100, more or less, this is not mine. I shouldn't feel that way. I feel like part of being, how do we say thank you, O Allah? When God gave you something, you say thank you, and you move on. But that's not the way. When God gave you eyes, how to thank Him for these eyes? If you see a blind person who needs to be guided, you stand there to be his eyes. This is how you say thank you, O God, for this eyesight. When you are given strength, muscles, and you are at the airport and you saw a lady carrying a heavy luggage, you jump in. And by saying thank you, O Allah, thank you, God, for the muscles that you give me, for the strength that you give me, the way you are doing it, by sharing this strength. Say, oh, lady, let me carry this luggage for you. And that goes with every kind of blessing that you are given, that there is a thankfulness to say thank you by tongue. It doesn't work. وَالَّذِينَ فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ مَعْلُومٌ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. To these who are beggars and al-mahroom, and for those who are deprived. There could be anyone could be in that condition. If we stand side by side as human, for all humanity, can you imagine how our planet will be? Will be paradise. We can make our planet a paradise if we reach out to one another. I'm not going to fill my tummy with more than what I can handle, or fill up my fridge with more than what I can have. And there are out there, especially now, we are in the month of fasting. We fast from dawn. I know some friends who are not Muslim, some friends who are Catholic, and they are saying, we are going to fast with you. Today I went to my car mechanic. I said, I'm fasting with you. I like to experience this. And I tell them, you know, the simplest thing that we can say, we become appreciative of the food, that we take it for granted. And also, then we feel for someone who doesn't have. I'm fasting, but there is a meal waiting for me at the end of the day. I'm fasting, but by choice, there are some other people who are fasting, but not with their choice. It's the circumstances that made them in a famine. They are not waiting. They are not waiting. They don't anticipate, they don't know when the next meal is going to come. So those are still the characters of those who perform the Salat. So if you perform the Salat, these characters, I want you to take this ayat and put it in a frame and share it with your friends. Say, you do the salat, alhamdulillah, you removed the obligation of performing the salat from your shoulder. But did it benefit you? Did you get the reward from it? Some people, their prayer, they don't get anything out of it. I ask Allah that one, not from those. والذين يصدقون بيوم الدين. الذين يصدقون بيوم الدين. Those who believe in the day of Deen. I'm going to use it as it is because حقيقة يعني and I'm hopeful that sometime in the future I'm thinking of reflecting on the seerah of the Prophet. That's what stopped me here. Reflecting on the seerah of the Prophet directly from the Quran. The Quran was revealed 23 years to coincide with all kinds of incidents and events from Badr to Uhud to Khaybar to Tabuk and so on and so forth. And the Quran does not side by anyone, while human do. Our history, our historian have been affected in one way or another by the rulers, and accordingly they wrote the seerah of the Prophet in such a way that marginalized what is important, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not favor anyone. We're all under the Prophet and Allah when it comes to the Quran. The Quran comes to address all humanity with no distinction. So I'm really thinking to come back and revisit this. You'll be surprised because now this ayah, وَالَّذِينَ يُصَدِّقُونَ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ. Now we find the historian, they made يَوْمِ الدِّينِ, يَوْمِ الْحَشْرِ, يَوْمِ الْبَعْثِ, يَوْمِ الْحِسَابِ. All of them the same. Where when this world get destroyed and the planet get destroyed, يوم القيامة. They made it all one thing. While it's not redundant. But the historian, they want to sum lump it in one thing for a purpose. Allahu a'lam. The same when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about al-Muslim wal-Mu'min. They are not. They want to make it this one type of Muslim, one type of Mu'min, one type of Munafiq, and one type of Kafir. But there is a variety of all. There is different levels that you, when you reflect, يعني, when Allah, when the Prophet is complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّهُمْ اتَّخَذُوا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. Quran, you tell someone the ayat of the Quran, I don't want to get out of the topic. There is so much, my dear brothers and sisters. وَالَّذِينَ يُصَدِّقُونَ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ. And those who believe in the day of deen, the day of righteousness, the day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will correct everything. Now, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. And those who are fearful from that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unhappy with them. I see some dear friend from none other than Ireland on this. I ask Allah said that the kids, that we benefit ourselves, يعني, inshallah. And people from Masjid al-Nur, of course, I'm doing this on Facebook and on Zoom because the last few weeks I've been doing it with Zoom. And that's why people on Facebook, they said, we haven't seen you. And so I'm doing it now on both. I wish there is a way. I'm sure there is a way to do it both with the same tool. But now I have two units in front of me, one for Zoom and one for Facebook. وَالَّذِينَ يُصَدِّقُونَ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. They are really fearful that they are not making the Creator happy with them. They are not doing the right things. They want to make sure they are doing the right things so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّهِمْ غَيْرُ مَعْمُونَ. See, this character, that that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's anger, it's not, nobody is safe. You have to be on your guard non-stop as you are day to day. You cannot say, I am contented in my belief. I'm happy with where I am. I'm good. I'm okay. Every minute, every day that we have to continue worrying ourselves, doubting ourselves, making sure that we are doing the right thing. We have seen that great example. Why those great Sahaba set the example? You see, when you see them talking about themselves, you feel like they are, they've done so much horrendous things, but they are in a constant weariness that they have not done. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّهِمْ غَيْرُ مَأْمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. They are holding their chastity. They are protecting their chastity. They are keeping themselves clean. Can you imagine the benefit to the individual so far? The benefit to the individual, the benefit to the family, the benefit to the society. That's why I was really thinking that probably, and that's most likely, people will choose this way of life, the way of Islam, but by choice. They will come to conclusion after this by the الذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملكون. Except that they are with their family, they experience the relationship. فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون. Whoever go beyond that, whoever transgress beyond that, they are considered عادون. They are considered transgressor. They are considered unjust. Unjust to whom? First of all, unjust to themselves. Then unjust to the surrounding. Unjust to the society. Now, those are very, very, very important characters. I said from the beginning, there are 9 characters, and we're not done with them. This important character belongs to al-musallun, those who are keeping their salat. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that our brothers and our friends and our family in Ireland, they are doing well with the coronavirus going on, that and as well as in Sinai. I see some people from Sinai. I see some people from other places. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, so subhanAllah, so look how this technology brought us. So I see the younger brothers from Masjid al-Nur, their mothers sitting them to benefit from this ayat. This ayat, my young sisters, are intended for al-musalleen, those who are performing the salat. I want you to go back and in the future, when I do the reflection, I want everyone to hold the Quran, because we may need to read the verse again and again to get some angles, to look at some ways that we can understand it, inshallah. وَالَّذِينَ لأمانتي. See, I'm not saying this out of nonsense. When Allah is telling us, I'm closing the whole masajid, go out. Go review your salat. How many people, they go to the salat and they make it and then they leave out to indulge in this life? لا أمانات ولا عهد ولا شيء. والذين هم لأمانتهم وعهدهم راعون. This is vital. This is important. That someone trusts you, you keep this trust. I see that trust in some other places. I don't want to put someone down or someone up, but we really need to review. Just take these characters of al-musalli. Inna salata tanha an al-fahsha'i wal-munkar wal-baghi. Salah, if we take these characters and put it in the fridge and review them in the morning as you are about to do your salat and you see them again, it becomes your habit. It becomes your, as the salat is a tradition that you are performing, also your character becomes upright as well. Allah. حياكم الله أستاذ الفاضل أستاذ رشدي حياكم الله أستاذ الفاضل. والذين هم لأمانتهم وعهدهم راعون. يعني how many people go to the salat and they don't keep the amana, they don't keep the عهد. The عهد, the simplest عهد. When I say I'm going to meet you, وعد, عهد is bigger. I'm talking about the simple thing that I say, I'm going to meet you at 4 o'clock. I make my utmost intention. That's what I'm going to do. That I'm going to meet you at 4 o'clock. I'm not taking it in a lazy way. وَالَذِينَهُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ الْأَمَانَ. And can you imagine someone being harassed for 13 years? And chased out of his town. And this man, nobody else they can trust to put their money or their wealth with, except with him. It's a paradox that really makes you in a state of awe. That this man named Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that people trusted him. الصادق الأمين. He's the ultimate example that we follow. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. يعني this ayat didn't come to entertain us, but every verse, every word has a specific meaning and that it's intended for. Al-amana, this Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has trust, people trusted wealth with him, that when they want it, they can find it. Now he's going to leave the whole town, being chased out of town. They are coming to kill him because of his message. He leaves behind his cousin, Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, so that he can give back this trust that belongs to the people. Maybe by today's political standard, I will take this trust with me because I'm leaving town. I need it. I'm going there to a new place. I need some money. I need some wealth, I'll take this, and maybe even with the intention that I'll pay them back. But look at the وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. Those who are, they watch this amana carefully. They watch the ahd. When I have a ahd, when I have a covenant, a contract between me and someone else. I abide. I do this contract with a true intention not to play with it. وَالَذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. Now the next one is a serious challenge to al-musalleen. You are making salat. The next one, I'm taking you, of course, each one, there's so many examples. I'm really not going into them. I am just passing through so that we take the benefit. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِشَهَادَاتِهِمْ قَائِمُونَ. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِشَهَادَاتِهِمْ قَائِمُونَ. يعني also one of the disastrous tafaseer and that we made shahada is the one whom get martyr. But as shahada, to shahid al shay. جزء منها, part of it when someone, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَا الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا في سبيل الله أموال. قتلوا مقتولين. It wasn't used the word شهادة. شهداء. شهداء means they are witnessing. They are a witness. والذين هم بشهاداتهم قائمون. Those who stand up with their witness. They don't witness and speak lies. We have seen that people do their salat in one hand, and the first minute he gets a chance to give a fabricated witness, he will do it. Oh, he's so and so. Of course, I'm not trying to get into politics, but I'm asking myself and asking everyone to watch oneself, to see that when we stand up to say, we watch what we say. أَوَنَحْنُ مُحَاسَبُونَ. Are we going to be held accountable even for what we say? Of course. Not only that. And this is going to surprise some people. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, قُلْ إِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوا يُحَاسِبُكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. We find this is an ayah, this is a constitution. قُلْ إِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبُ. If whatever you are doing, you are holding inside, or you are actually performing it, in both cases, you are held accountable. I don't know from where they come with a hadith to contradict a clear ayah from the Quran. That if you thought of something and you didn't do it, how are you, Pere? I hope you are doing well. This is St. Joe. And give my greeting to the great leader over there. Brian. I was just trying to remember his name. A great leader indeed, who invited me to his church to raise money, to raise funds for the children of Gaza. This is a church. And I'm glad that she is here so that I can speak in front of her. They performed the Sunday twice, one in the morning and one in the afternoon. And each one, there is like 2,000 plus 3,000. And I was the guest speaker over there to talk to them. And I was the main topic, actually. May God bless you. May God gather us together to save our planet. We put our hands together. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِشَهَادَاتِهِمْ قَائِمُونَ. Those who are standing with their truthfulness. How many people say fake things to benefit someone who is powerful? This is how we really got things got out of the world, get out of hand, if you will, when we speak to please someone while it's not really part of his character. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِشَهَادَاتِهِمْ قَائِمُونَ. Now when you review these nine characters of al-musalleen, I want you to go back and do the salat again. And when you do the salat, you want to make sure that these characters are part of you. Otherwise, what is this salat is doing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. Those who are keeping their salat, protecting their salat. They are doing the proper things to make this salat a function in their life. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ مُكْرَمُونَ. They are the kind of one. He would be in Jannat. He would be in paradise. مكرمون. يعني they will be honored. Honored by who? When you are honored by the mayor of town, see how it feels. When you are honored by the governor of the state, you see how it feels. When you're honored by the president of a country, you see how it feels. But you can imagine when you are honored by the creator of the universe, by your creator, the one who created you and created all these planets, all this universe, and here he is honoring you. What a special thing. What a special. أُولَٰئِكَ فِي جَنَّاتِ مُكْرَمُونَ. So I will stop here so that I ask myself and I ask everyone else to think again as we are performing our salat that we have this character when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ مَنُوعًا إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ الذين هم على صلاتهم دائمون والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم للسائل والمحروم والذين يصدقون بيوم الدين والذين هم من عذاب ربهم مشفقون إن عذاب ربهم غير مأمون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون والذين هم لأماناتهم وعهدهم راعون والذين هم بشهاداتهم قائمون والذين هم على صلاتهم يحافظون أولئك في جنات مكرمون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Now if I take you to Surah Al-Mu'minun, also قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. They are successful, the one who are believers. Who are those mu'minun, O Allah? This is the verse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is in Surah Al-Mu'minun. Both Surah Al-Ma'arij and Surah Al-Mu'minun من السور المكية. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون. So they are in their prayer in a state of خشوع, a state of contemplation. They are completely focused in that they are in front of the of their Creator Almighty. They are in state of full humbleness and humility in front of the Creator of the universe. الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون. They are the one who are shy, who shy away from vain talk, who when they see vain talk, talk that is nonsense, that is not benefiting anyone, they stay away from it. Is this part of the character of the believer who hold their prayer? وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. And those who hold their chastity, they are clean. They hold themselves to their family. They keep their health. Look, the benefit to the individual, but then look at the benefit to the family, then look at the benefit to the society. When I've talked earlier about this nine characters of the prayer of the musallin, of those who hold their prayer, and also here the characters of the mu'mineen, of the believers, those who are in complete khushu', complete humbleness and humility in the salat, those who are stay away from vain talk, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلٌ, those who gives charity, those who are charity givers, I give some. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ, those who are holding their chastity, keeping themselves clean, إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ, they are only with their wives, a wife with her husband, a husband with their wife, keeping a healthy society, keeping a healthy community. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَعُونَ, the same as in Surah Al-Ma'arij, here in Surah Al-Mu'minun, the same character. الَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَعُونَ, they are trustworthy with their amana, with the trust. If you trust them with something, they hold it. You come back, whenever you come back, your trust is there. They hold it for you. They save it for you. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ, and when there is a covenant between him or her and other people, they hold this. When there is a contract, when there is an agreement, they hold this agreement to their highest level. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ, those who keep their prayer, they keep their regular prayer, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ, they are the ones who are going to inherit. They are the inheritor. What are they going to inherit? الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ الْأَعْلَىٰ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ, those who are going to inherit the highest ranking, the highest level that you can think of. وَهُمْ فِيهَا, هُمْ فِيهَا, they are going to be there for eternal, forever. So, as we reflect on these characters of the believers and the characters of those who perform the salat, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are from amongst those who perform the salat and performs the obligations that comes with the salat, that keeps the character of the individual correct, that makes the individual a benefit to himself or to herself, a benefit to his or her surrounding, a benefit to the society at large, a benefit to the planet as well, that our planet as well. As I am concluding here, I ask God Almighty, the creator of the universe, to relieve us all from this pandemic that we are going through, this pain, this losses of life that has been going on, that there's an end to that, O God Almighty, that O God Almighty, bring us to your realm, to your rounding, to your place, to your pleasure, with kindness, with your kindness, and with your love. And as we are also going through this time of fasting, this is the month of Ramadan, and interestingly, the month of Ramadan, part of it is that we go in seclusion. Part of the Ramadan, we do prayer with others, and we break our fast at sunset, and sometime we also go part of this time in seclusion So the whole world actually is in seclusion. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting and to make us from those who benefit from the fasting in this life and in the hereafter. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for our shortcomings and to forgive our parents who passed before us and our ancestors who passed before us and our relatives who are not here with us. Those who passed away just a few days ago or a few weeks ago due to this calamity that is touching all of us. I ask you, O God, to have mercy on all of us. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.